Thank you. Actually drove up by bus from the, you know, U.S. I mean, that's pretty good, you know, from like Erie, Pennsylvania, places like that. Boy, must be a long ride. Anyway, thank you everybody for coming tonight. Marlene, this is for you. Happy birthday.
I'm
Jackson with a very beautiful song.
Thank you.
Well, it's nice to be here in Canada again, I must say. One of the nicest reasons I can think of is the audiences here are very sophisticated. Oh yeah, sure they are. Oh yeah, definitely. Very sophisticated. Audiences here, thank goodness, they don't want to hear those raggedy old broken down used car songs we used to do. Oh sure, nobody up here wants to hear a song called Little Deuce Coupe or anything like that. And those other stupid songs like Little Old Lady from Pasadena. Thank goodness they're more sophisticated here in Canada than all that. Not to mention all those other songs like 409 and Shutdown and Little GTR and Get Around. So thank goodness we're where we don't have to do that kind of stuff anymore. You know what I mean? 20 years of it. What a relief, what a relief. But I'll tell you, we're no fools. We know where we are. We're in Gordon Lightfoot country and stuff. Yeah, oh yeah, sure. Oh yeah. That too. And it's surprising how many Canadians love that country music. Oh. Did I have the right instincts tonight or what?
Beautiful.
Yes, indeed. How about some more country?
Yeah.
How about no more of those car songs? Thank goodness. Yeah. Now, it'd be stupid to do those car songs. You got to admit, because half the audience here tonight wasn't even born when we first came out with them. Nobody probably would have heard them. Well, that's always from their parents' album or something. Of course, there is a possibility that a lot of the people here tonight are here because of those cars. I don't know. Well, I'm not afraid.
I introduced you to a friend of mine who joined the group in 1965. His name is Bruce Johnston, ladies and gentlemen. Not everybody knows this, but Bruce wrote a song which is one of the most, successful, most popular songs of all time. It was called I Write the Songs. He actually wrote it, not Barry Manilow. We want him to do it for you right now. Come, Bruce.
Hi, everybody. We'd like to thank Eaton's for procuring our new clothing line. You know, Beach Boy clothes. They've had incredible displays, and we're really proud to be associated in the Eaton family. Look, I don't know how well I'm going to do his next song, but we had this really weird review. I don't think a reviewer came, because he said that this next song is definitely a Holiday Inn staple. Well, that's okay, but you know, someone had to write the song first, you know, 10 years ago before it got played every place around the world. And you're hearing this song from the writer. I'm the writer of this song, so this is for me.
Can you sing this? What are you singing? we're traveling around Canada. We're doing a cross-Canadian tour right now. We started in the west of Canada, and we've worked our way out here to Hamilton. We're going to be on our way up to Quebec, or Montreal. When we get up these parts of the beautiful part of the world, we start thinking about our own state of California. Kind of a place that we grew up in, especially in the northeast. We start getting little thoughts of that place, you know what I mean? So we sing a song about our home state.
Walk on.
Del Shannon's obviously a big star up here too. Thank you very much. Can we do the Dumpy Doo song? We're gonna do another little one like that. We do a little 50s medley occasionally. Something like this, a little street corner harmony. It starts with one voice and spreads out into a group. A dum 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 dum
Oh, Wow.